Both Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders saw their poll numbers jump after the Democratic debate, with Hillary's numbers going even higher. But in a potential matchup between the Republican frontrunner, Bernie holds a significant advantage. Joining me now to explain what these polls mean for the election is journalist H.A. Goodman. So Hal, a lot of the polling that the media has been focusing on is it going to be Hillary? Is it going to be Bernie? Who's at the top of the Democratic? Who's at the top of the Republicans? But when it comes to a general election, those sides aren't going to be going up against each other. We need to start looking at which Democrats can beat the Republicans. And the latest polling kind of gives us an answer on that, doesn't it?
Absolutely. When you look at Real Clear Politics, you can see that Bernie Sanders already beats Donald Trump. So he already defeats Donald Trump at a wider margin than Clinton would. So Sanders is beating Donald Trump in a variety of polls by over 5 points. Clinton barely goes over 3 points. So in terms of who can actually win for Democrats, Bernie Sanders not only can win a general election, but he can defeat Donald Trump by a wider margin. And really quickly, in terms of Clinton versus Trump, I think Trump is a buffoon. I don't think he should be anywhere near the White House, but he's very, very good at attacking an opponent's weaknesses. In terms of weaknesses, Hillary Clinton, her biggest weakness, in addition to the scandals and the FBI investigation, because the FBI is not part of a GOP. So all Trump has to do is say, hey, you know what? This isn't Benghazi. This is the Federal Bureau of Investigation. And you know his mannerisms and the way his arrogance, he can come across in a debate as saying, hey, I'm the only candidate here who isn't being investigated by the FBI, and Democrats would lose. But one thing that really hurts Clinton, and this is the biggest advantage of Bernie Sanders over Trump, is that Bernie Sanders is the antithesis of Donald Trump. So you need a foil for that type of person. Really, what he's running on is his brash persona, the fact that he's this, you know, conservative, brash type of reality star. Hillary Clinton is conservative, and she is a moderate to actually conservative Republican on a variety of things, especially foreign policy. She has neoconservative advisors on Wall Street. I mean, her links are, there's so many links that she has to Wall Street. So all Trump has to say is, hey, if you want a Republican, vote for me. You don't have to vote for Hillary Clinton, who's a quote unquote moderate. Just vote for me. But Bernie Sanders is the antithesis. Bernie Sanders wins already by a wider margin, and he is the absolute best choice. I fear a Trump presidency if it's Clinton versus Trump. And yeah.
Well, you know, what's interesting is as you pointed out, Trump really is this larger than life figure. He has this huge presence about him, and Bernie Sanders is more of, I'm one of you. He doesn't have to go out there and say things like that because we know it. He's one of the only members in the House or the Senate that's not a millionaire. Last time I looked, I believe his net worth, all assets, everything combined, is about $250,000, which means, like most Americans, he owns his home.
Yep.
And that's it. So, you know, he's not this brash billionaire guy who wants to bully everybody around. He's the guy who says, look, things suck right now. They're pretty bad. Let's do something to make it better. Let's not demonize, you know, a person. Let's go to Wall Street where these organizations, these faceless, nameless groups are taking our money away. They're taking our livelihoods away. And Hillary does not have that because, again, she is also, in her own way, this larger-than-life figure. We've seen her for 25 years now in the national spotlight. She is, as Donald Trump is, a celebrity at this point. So I think Bernie has a very big strength there because people don't want the celebrity anymore. They don't want, you know, the bully, the brashness. And both Trump and Hillary have very strong personalities. But, you know, when it comes down to who can use it better, unfortunately, I believe Trump, being the biggest bully in the room, would absolutely have his way with them, whereas he doesn't have much to tack Bernie on, does he?
No, absolutely. You're absolutely right. First of all Trump has to say is, well, you know what, Hillary, you gave me or I gave you $100,000 for your foundation. I helped you in your Senate runs. So in terms of a candidate that's supposed to be different from Trump, she accepted money from Trump. So there's an upcoming article I'm going to write. It's basically, the theme is, don't complain about your country if you vote for Clinton or Trump, because Bernie Sanders is telling you, hey, I want to break up the banks. I want to reinstate a Glass-Steagall. I want to prevent a never-ending perpetual counterinsurgency wars. I want to do all these things. I want to focus on the middle class. I want to focus on reducing wealth inequality. These are all the things that Trump and Clinton are just going to go ahead and say, hey, I'll do this, but they're not going to reinstate Glass-Steagall. They're not going to break up the banks. They're not going to go ahead and focus on college tuition. They're not going to focus on real issues. They're going to say, well, you know, they're going to pay lip service to things. Bernie Sanders is a great Bernie Sanders offers voters an actual choice. So if there's Trump, Clinton, there's two similar, people will just say, you know what, I like Trump better. Because right now, 55% of Americans, according to CNN, have an unfavorable view of Hillary Clinton. So if people say, oh, the polls, there's one poll that says she has negative favorability ratings in terms of that. And in terms of trustworthiness, swing states, Quinnipiac has swing states, swing state polls, they don't trust Clinton. And 57% of Americans, according to CNN in a Yahoo article, do not trust Clinton. So,
well, what's very interesting about this is that you're talking about a lot of polls that we're not hearing about anywhere else. All we're seeing is the result. Hillary Clinton has this much support, Bernie Sanders this much, then O'Malley, Chafee, Lessig after that, which I guess now that Webb's out, Lessig is finally getting some numbers here, which not a bad guy. I'm not picking on him at all. But we're not looking at the bigger picture here. Favorability matters. I mean, Barack Obama was always through the roof because people loved him. They loved his personality. By far, probably the coolest American president we will ever have. But, you know, he didn't have these net unfavorables that Hillary Clinton did. And that's what tanked her in the 2007-2008 primaries. And those have not changed, have they, since then?
No, they haven't. In fact, they've increased. And there was a, this is how the, there's such spin regarding these polls. So there was a CBS News article recently said, Clinton keeps her lead. Okay. And I actually read the article, and it says at the bottom of the article, 14% of Democrats will not support Clinton. 14%. And then there's something like over 10% would only support way over 10% would only support Clinton if they had to. So in terms of, and Bernie Sanders was right, if Democrats don't go to the polls and if there's not enthusiasm, Republicans win. And we saw that already with Congress. So Bernie Sanders is the only Democrat who will galvanize not just the base, but all Democrats to get to the polls, because he actually embodies what a Democrat is supposed to be in terms of value system. Hillary Clinton is a moderate, and she's conservative. She's a Republican on a lot of things. A lot of people are not going to either not go or just say, you know what, I'm disgusted with the whole process. And some people might just protest the election. So I think that Bernie Sanders is really the only hope to prevent Donald Trump from having access to our nuclear launch codes. So,
unfortunately, we're out of time. But Hal Goodman, this is phenomenal work here. Thank you for telling us the story, and we will check back in with you very soon.
Thank you so much, Farron. Thank you.